Hey, I am back with the In-Between Tarot, and this is another free reading. This is the box from... This tarot deck is from Janine Worthington and Franco Rivoli, exploring the spiritual space between the arcana. And I'm going to use the book because I'm practicing, but I'm getting better at it. So, you wanted to know about your vacation, not a holiday, but a vacation. So this is about you, this is about your wife, and this is about your little princess. Let's do these first, and I'm just going to make a new rainbow. There we go, and this is about you. You are so ready for a lot of joy, taking care of your daughter, let others do the hard work, and you so deserve it. This goes from the Queen of Coins to the King of Coins, and you are ready to pass on knowledge and wisdom and joy and jokes and fun from queen to king. Material comfort and prosperity, that's the queen. The king is discipline and the provider, and the in-between concept is being and becoming a breadwinner. So it says the movement from Queen of Coins to the King of Coins shows somebody who is self-sufficient and who has to take on more of a leadership role. So don't be everybody's best friend, but also be a leader. And the in-between stage shows the ultimate responsibility. The transition is hefty and demanding, but one where you can feel ultimately in control of at least the material aspect. So that's covered. I never had doubts about that. But you are also full of love and care and, you know, not afraid to put in the hard work and be compassionate and funny and caring at the same time. So that's a good one. Now we are going to your lovely wife. She is still struggling, and it's a card that's in between the Hangman and Death. The Hangman is all about trying to look at things in a new way, having a new perspective, and Death is shaking off the ego and not being ruled by anger and frustration and sadness and things like that. Now, in your situation, that totally makes sense, but I'm going to check the book. And this is card number 12. I had this for somebody yesterday. It's the Hangman is about reflection and introspection, and Death is about transformation and resurrection, and the in-between concept is the release of ego and fears and doubts and stuff like that. When this in-between concept presents itself, we feel that we have gone from a period of stillness and uncertainty and are moving into a cleansing change process. It will feel like a weight has been lifted from our shoulders, and that it has taken a long time to realize. We have now clear our vision of what will happen going forward. Albeit painful and complicated, at least there is now a feeling of approaching a state of closure. So that's a good thing. I think this vacation is going to help your wife immensely in, you know, shaking off all the things that you were struggling with. So this is your little princess. Seven of Wands. I think she would have loved to bring her boyfriend with her, but it is what it is. He has to go to school, and I'm not sure they're leaving the campsite. I hope they are not going. She's not going to disappear on you. And back off or back away. She is, I think, a little bit, you know, disappointed that he couldn't come with. It's attack, defense, but also movement and action. And she would love to escape the situation. I think this is something that you were already afraid of. The in-between stage of defense in the Seven of Wands to movement in the Eight of Wands is abandonment. When a situation is no longer working, sometimes it's for the best to just let it go up and in flames. So, oh, she's going through a very hard time. I want to have a clarifier on how she feels like when you arrive at your destination. So I always mess up my beautiful aura or rainbow of cards. So this one is upside down. So Chariot. This is about protection and defense, and accept that you guys will take care of her. And it's about the lovers. So if that's the little girl, then she is ready to surrender to your protection and care, which is a good one. Let me check for just in case. I don't want to miss something. So this is communication and making a choice, movement and protection. This in-between stage gives a sense of purpose and forward movement to the family. They are deciding on what their next move should be and what they need to do next in order to feel safe and secure. That's what she needs. She is ready to surrender, but not here before you leave. She's not willing and a little bit resistant and frustrated, but she's getting there. That's the upward meaning. And then we go to the Eight of Cups. That's another clarifier of what you can do to help her out and support her and guide her through the vacation, because she is with you and your wife and as an only child, which is still so sad. Eight of Coins and Nine of Coins, Cups, sorry. She feels lost, but also ready to move. Contentment and wishes granted. Just spoil her. Spoil her even more than you already do, and everything will be fine. The sun shines brightly onto the water and reminds her that it's helpful to have this time to be still and think about her next move. So she needs this. She isn't aware of it yet, but she needs it. She can't run away. She can't get out of the situation. She is almost ready to, you know, let you and your wife take care of her. And then there is, you know, light at the end. The sun shining at the horizon, or hope there. Then we go to how traveling will be, which is kind of cool. This is a lot of joy. So you will have fun. And there's a lot of romance going on and a lot of joy, emotions, Six of Cups, going toward Seven of Cups, which matches perfectly with this card. And here we go. It's innocence and choices and disillusions and choose another path. So instead of, you know, making it all heavy and you're ready. You are totally ready. But, and your daughter will get there. She will accept, your guidance and help and you cheering her up. But, you know, ready for transformation, new insights. And this is about traveling. This in-between stage looks at the exchange, which is about to happen between the pair. The woman has not yet fully acknowledged the man, but is ready to surrender. When this card shows up, it will show a lapse of concentration where the person can still retract the decision they are about to make before they are in too deep. Too many tempting options surround us, and we often can often feel overwhelmed by them in this in-between stage. So maybe you have too many things on the agenda and it's more about being together and having fun and making jokes and laugh together and cry together and, you know, just enjoy being together instead of keeping yourself distracted and busy with everything that's on the menu. This is about the destination that goes towards the tower. It might be a little bit of a shaky road, but you know, there will be balance. Balance between good and bad. So that's one thing. The goal was to be, I don't know what the goal was, but doesn't matter. You have to really fight for what you want and what you believe. Six of Swords, Two Swords, Seven. Six of Swords towards Seven. This is a hard one. We don't need the Wands, we need the Swords, and we need the Six, and we need the Seven. So I think that you really have to work hard. That already is in this card, but you are full of love and protection, and these windows are in churches. What are they called in English? Put in the hard work. Be strategic. Sometimes, you know, hide a little bit. Don't get in the way. You might feel a little bit unsettled. And it might be difficult, but you will be able to get through this. So just another card for the fun of it. And let's go with this one. Oh, this is cute. This is matches exactly with this one. So if this is you and this is the end goal, then you're fine. But it's not going to be easy all the way down. There's a lot of love here. There's a little bit of an issue here. Hard work. Sometimes, you know, hard work needs to be... Vacations aren't always easy. I don't know what it is with vacation, but here, this is the angel protecting you. And protection, educating, guiding, loving, passing on your gifts, passing on your knowledge, passing on your jokes to the next generation. So these are good. But well, I think this is it. See you next time. Bye.